So Maxine Cannon?
Conner.
Conner.
So Maxine Conner, I come from Los Angeles, Suwannee County. So as a support, I'm always up here today to help out the community. Thank you for allowing public input, we know it's on the agenda today. I volunteer in Citrus County as Natural Resources Chair for the Women Voters of Citrus County. Also as Conservation Chair for Sierra Club Citrus County as well. So both organizations embrace sustainability, which is defined as filling needs in the present with our farming needs in the future. So the key words here are needs versus wants, and also the word farm. So if the permit is granted, it doesn't appear to meet the definition of sustainability on its face. So I do have one question. If the permit is granted, would your MFLs then protect from overpumping? That's one question I have to figure out in my mind. And a previous speaker mentioned plastic water bottles, which I'm really not contending with here today, but that's one of the unintended consequences of making a decision like this that we, you know, can't control, but then become part of the waste stream, which is already overtaxed, polluting our oceans and becoming microplastics, which is even more serious because you can't reverse that, and they are being ingested by wildlife and sea life, and now they are entering our food chain, so that's an unintended consequence that we want. So I ask you today to please make any decisions that you have power to make to protect the water supply needs now and for the future. And I also appreciate your service and I thank you for all that you do. The league is a great educational tool, and we have the educational facets of your organization as well, which do a lot of great good. So our laws and regulations should protect our water resources for now and the future. If overpumping is allowed, the detriment of our rivers and springs, which are already impaired, we all know, then the laws and regulations need to be changed, and so that going forward, we have sustainability. So I realize you have to operate within the parameters of the laws and regulations in place. If your board has statutory authority and discretion in this matter, I would strongly ask you to protect the natural resource of Jenny Springs and this river basin and our aquifer from overpumping. This would be true sustainability, which would fill the current needs and not wants without harming the needs of the future, and this is truly in the public interest. People really care about these beautiful natural resources and their current and future water supply. Thank you again for what you do. I believe you care as well. And I would strongly ask you to please use whatever authority or discretion that you have to deny the Jenny Springs permit and to protect the public's water resources for now and the future of the demand. And I noted as I was listening, I learned a lot by listening to the speakers, which are so knowledgeable. A previous speaker made a great point saying that if the current laws and regulations don't give you the authority that you need to protect our springs, rivers, and the public water supply from depletion, please work with the concerned citizens and organizations like the Florida Springs Institute and the Florida Springs Council to change laws and regulations to give you the authority that you need to protect our springs, rivers, and public water supply, and all of us. Thank you so much for allowing us to speak today.